Good morning to all. Sorry for this technical inconvenience. So today's session is completely regarding towards Python programming as well as its applications. So today we will be going towards the complete application towards Python. So there won't be any of the basic programming. Directly we will be introducing what was the application or what will be the currently going on towards a technological level. Pantech has been origined during the year of 2004. We have almost 7 branches. We have 100 plus employees, and we also conducted more than 1200 workshops. So by yesterday we have completed our 100 webinars within the short period of this lockdown. We have R&D for industrial projects. We also conduct faculty development programs, hands-on training workshops, internships and in-plant training, short-term courses, value-added courses, academic project training, customized design services at the state of R&D. So we have been expertised in these domains such as Internet of Things, Artificial Intelligence, Embedded System, VLSI, FPGA, TMS Processor, Image Processing with OpenCV as well as MATLAB, Network Simulation, Power Electronics, Electric Vehicle. Also towards the CSE as well as IT domains, Big Data, Data Analytics, Internet of Things, Python, Android Application Development, Data Image Text Mining and Cloud Computing. So today's course outline will be Introduction towards the Python, Application of Python, Execution of Basic Application, Conclusion. So let us start with the intro towards the Python. So generally if we go for like this programming languages, definitely we have many different types of programming languages over here, right? So these and all cannot be said as a technology, right? Because programming, most of the programming will be acting as a back end or as a front end for the particular technology depending upon which we use. Mostly the end product, no one is going to analyze what is the programming structure of this. So they are looking only for the forward of that particular device, right? For example, a mobile phone. So in early periods, whenever the mobile phone started, there was no programming at all, I can say so, because everything is completely regarding towards that entire session, or we can be say it as a that logical applications towards the IC. So it can be reading that binaries and all, the oldest mobile. So even though they have been designed with the help of embedded system, we cannot say that it is a completely a programming, or only the some part may be relating towards some basic codings like VHDL, or regarding towards that Xilinx or in that way. Okay. So the later on when the mobile has been implemented with many of the features such as camera, music or FM radio, they have created some languages. They have created the softwares with the help of some languages, mostly known as Java. Then we have come to know that Java oriented phones. So whenever if we turn on any of the application within that, we can see that logo of the Java. So by that we will come to know that it has been developed completely by the Java organization, right? Nothing but the Oracle. So therefore during that period, that was high in the market. So why it was high in the market, in the sense due to the n number of applications, because even they have released even that touch oriented apps also for the touch phones, especially in the Nokia mobile. So whenever if you go for that Nokia oriented mobiles, they were only most famous for this Java oriented applications. Later on the Samsung. So there were some evolutions regarding towards a complete application towards this. Okay. So therefore, regarding towards this end application, it depends upon the back-end codings and all. So it may be any of the web application, or it may be regarding towards a gaming application, or we can go with the music application or photography application, everything. Okay. And later on, they have been implemented, start to work with those OS, because later on the OS has been completely changed by the Google, nothing but known as Android, right? So Android is one kind of the OS that has been developed by the Google. I don't know what kind of language they are using, but the applications that are completely made with the help of Android Studio, right? So Android Studio, there also we are using the C++ compiled program. So by this combined application only, we are completely using this kind of all the applications whichever we are seeing. So those who have tried to develop some of the apps, they might have known how the evolution of the languages has been updated. So each and every platform, they are keeping on changing according to their needs. So whenever they have completely moved on, therefore we can the current trend or the trend that has been started around past 5 to 6 years, among that it comes as a Python. So let it be the different programming languages. So these programming languages which and all we have said, it comes under the high level programming languages, right? So this has been started during the year of early 1950s, I think so, 1950s or 60s, because during the 1969 itself the Python programming has been invented. So before that itself might have been they have started the complete C, then later on C++ and all. But whatever we are using, it becomes something late due to this lack of development in technology or lack of the awareness. So in order to create like this awarenesses only, these kind of webinars as well as the classes has been conducted nowadays for all the engineering students. Okay, so based on this kind of application, we can see many number of products in the market nowadays. Let it be any kind of software or any purposeful things. So previously we doesn't know how the image will be able to change it to black and white with the help of the digital cameras and all, right? We used to select a Python, or whenever if we use that particular functions, what to say, the video processing and the latest, not only latest, some of the Apple mobiles will be having that converting the normal video to the slow motion video. Now all the mobiles it has. So regarding that option and all, we doesn't know how it has been created. But when we started to learn with some of the applications with the coding, so then we come to know how this is able to do. So by reducing the frames per second, we can make the video a slow motion video. So that is nothing but one kind of application whichever we see. So even we have seen some of our webinars which has been done with video processing or image processing. So definitely whenever if we go for that application, the number of frames will be reduced in order to detect some of the techniques. So that is nothing but the frame reduction. So that has been directly applied towards a particular mobile phone, and for converting into the some of the scenery oriented colors. So converting one form of image into another, whereas our image will be in live itself. We can check whether this is suitable, this is not suitable, or what are the other packages that can be added, nothing but known as filters. So now these kind of things are we are doing completely with the help of that Python OpenCV, which and all we can see that different kinds of filters, or changing the colors, or separating some planes. Then later on we have been started this image processing towards application to integrating that image processing as well as the machine learning. That is nothing but machine is able to analyze towards with the help of live camera. So this and all nothing but completely it is using towards the as an upgrading level. Okay, so for that generally we have to know what is C, then C++, then we have to learn a little bit Java. Since it is famous, we have to know what is it, then only we will be able to know what kind of particular codings or what will be the syntax difference for each and everything. So and later on we nowadays everyone's curriculum is having this Python. But even though if they are learning that Python and they know that all the applications are there, many of them won't be able to know what is that particular Python, or how it has been used. Even you guys might have seen that there is audio function and you can get speech input. That is nothing but speech recognition possible. Then uploading data towards the cloud. So these are all the normal things only, but we have to see some how it is getting worked. So within this Python, we have two programming process, nothing but interpreters and compilers. So generally, if we go for the interpreters as well as the compilers, what is the difference between in the sense? Compiler, whenever we run the code, it finds the error and it does not even execute a single line until we clear out the particular error. But whereas interpreter, in the sense where the error is occurred, there it will be interrupting us. So based on that interruption only, we have to change the particular or clarify that particular error, then only we will be able to proceed towards the next function. So this will be the structure of the compiler. We will be providing the source code. Compiler compiles each and every line, and therefore object code will be from compiler, it will be converting towards the object code. Then it will be executing the particular output and it can be displayed as a output window. But whereas if we go for the interpreters, therefore whenever if we provide the source code towards the interpreter, it will execute whatever the particular correct lines are available. If it finds any of the wrong lines over there, therefore it will be displaying that particular error. So I think generally it is very easy to do with Python. So we can check till what it is working, and therefore we can rectify that particular error as easy as possible. Whereas in Java or C or C++, it is not possible because those are running with the help of compilers. Those who have any doubts, you can just post it in the chat box. And therefore, whenever we introduce this Python, it will be introduced as a high-level programming language, fast to learn, fast to develop application, available for many platforms, implement complex logic with very few lines of code. Generally, if you go with the same image processing with the help of C or C++, in the sense, we might have writing around 100 lines just to access the camera, because they don't have any of the high level application as a header files and all, like import CV2 in that way. But whereas since we are installing this directly towards the Python, therefore we will be able to access the camera and do some image processing. Within the 10 to 15 lines, and later on whenever if you are applying only the particular algorithm, it is getting exceeded than which we predicted it. So that is the way the Python became more familiar than we think. And interpreter actually doesn't produce the object code. Generally, it is nothing but we have to execute the complete output now. So this interpreter, in the sense, it will be executing each and every line by line. For example, at first I am giving that print hi, how are you, and next I will have done some syntax mistake. Okay, so therefore first it will be printing that hi, how are you, and then it will be printing that syntax error in this particular line. So that is the job of interpreter. Whereas compiler, it is not like that. Whenever if we run or compile the program, it will check all the lines and all the errors will be distributed at the same time. Yeah, definitely if you are worked in C or C++, you might have seen at the bottom they will be showing that particular error. So in that way only we will be classifying that entire error rectification, or we can say that warnings. So that even in C also it will be displaying that errors and all, but the difference is nothing but it will be displaying the overall errors. In Python we will be able to receive only the line by line errors. Almost interpreter runs faster than compiler. But nowadays that Python has become as an open source, so that many of the industries won't be able to develop some of the things with the help of Python. But using Python, these and all can be developed. Okay. So he is the inventor of Python. This has been invented in the year of early 1989, and the name of the guy is nothing but Guido van Rossum. So he has been implemented this particular technique. It is nothing but National Research Institute for Mathematics and Computer Science in Netherlands. So whatever the programming language that has been invented or the devices that has been invented, it is only for the purpose of calculation. Later only they have been changed it. For example, Charles Babbage, father of the computer, he was invented the computer only for the purpose of calculation, electronic calculation purpose. But later on nowadays what we are using it for, to watch the movies, right? So that is only that evolution as well as the technology change due to the development of each and every levels, and based on that binary codes only the C code has been provided. So based on the C code they have started to create a OS, then some basic applications. Later on from that coding itself we have generated other codings. So here it is written that how Python is related to C. The syntax, the coding structure, and we can say that each and some of the words we can write it as that while loop, if condition, if else condition. So in that way it will be relating that kind of C structures only. So whenever if we go for any of the programming, we have to be thorough with C. If you are ready to debug the errors from C or C++, then wherever you can get some of the, what to say, a higher level position. So the whenever if any of them is interested to learn the like this codings, open in order to work with C as well as C++. And nowadays everyone is learning the coding with the help of Arduino embedded system. So next it is nothing but completely regarding towards the application. So whenever if we go for this application, one of the most important application that currently we are using, it is nothing but signal processing. So what is the signal processing? So what are the different types of signals that has been used within this particular Python? So whenever if we go for the signal processing, we can say the two signals. One is audio and another one is image. So image signal processing is only the most famous signal processing whenever we come to Python. Nothing but image processing, machine learning, deep learning. So these are all completely done with the help of this signal processing only. So here the image will be taken as the signal. And based on the particular signal that has been given as input, the pre-processing as well as converting into the binary language in which the system will be able to understand it. And later on, the machine starts to learn it. And with the help of deep learning, the machine will be deeply analyzing towards it. Okay, so therefore signal processing plays a major role. And you might ask why image processing is only used in machine learning as well as deep learning. So it is not like that.
basically before this machine learning as well as deep learning, image processing also one part of the technology. So based on this image processing only we were able to acquire some of the digital cameras. So without that it is not possible, and this image processing technique usage only we are being enabled in order to as a back end of a Photoshop's. That has nothing but cropping. So it is nothing but cropping in the sense resizing, and we can also select the particular area, changing the color. So the color palette is already available. It is mixture of RGB. So this kind of you can apply some logics and just think what is that image processing, then how that it is related towards the current period of the Photoshop's or like this kind of applications. Okay, so whenever if you go for the signal, the image is also considered as a signal, therefore hence it is said as a signal processing. Even audio can also be directly given to this Python, and it can be processed according to the changes whichever we need, such as some of the audio cutting tools, or we can also make it some audio playing softwares. So everything is possible with the help of Python. Next is Pygame. So with the help of the Pygame, it is very easy to create some of the Python 3D. Generally, I don't know how many of them know that particular software named as Blender. It is especially used to create the graphics level only. So whenever if we go for that graphics oriented functions, therefore we can say that the coding part that has been combined with the help of Blender, it is nothing but Python only. So integrating that Python as well as that Blender only, the entire gaming or 3D animations, everything is being worked, because Blender is one of the software famous for creating like this graphic oriented functions. Whereas if you use that Unity 3D, therefore you will be using the C-sharp coding. So these and all just based on some of the application oriented or some softwares. So generally we might be seeing that with the help of Blender software, it is very easy to animation and all, there is no use of coding. So only the person who develops, he knows what is the use of the particular coding. So in order to turn that particular position of a character, if you want to move from one place to another place, we will be pressing the keys within that keyboard of the system. So therefore the key access must be there. Whenever if you are playing in our mobile, we will be having that virtual buttons. So with the help of the virtual buttons, the control should be taken. So like this, button controls and all done only with the help of Python. Exactly, Minecraft is one of the game that has been created with the help of Python. So Maya Python, this is mostly used for 3D development as well as CAD. So how it is in the sense, the same Blender only I can give you as an option. Even if you go for the Unity or digital reality like that developments and all, such as virtual engines, they will be also providing a platform with the Python. So once if you start just as an backend application or by the codings, then only we will be able to get whether we can move it towards that complete Python or we should mix up with some other languages. So with some other languages, and then for example in Unity platform we can call n number of languages. It may be C++, C#, Java, Python as well as HTML. Later on we can even compile that entire product towards the Android application. So that is one of the famous software which we are currently using. If you have any doubts, you can just post it towards the chat box. Yeah, generally if you are going with Tikinder, Tikinder is nothing but it is an application of GUI. You can integrate any of the GUI systems towards this Python. That is very easily possible. Yeah, for Python, if you want to get all kind of functions in the sense, you can go with W3 School or Geeks for Geeks. Yeah, Python is better than C. And application of power system, we'll be seeing shortly. Whenever it is connected towards the embedded system like Raspberry Pi or Jetson Nano, it can be used for power systems also. Yeah, Python is better than C. Yes, Python is better than C. Yes, Python is better than C. Many of them asking the same questions. Yeah, for video making also Python can be used. If you ask that whether it is harder than C in the sense, we can say it is little bit easier, but when the real-time application comes, there will be some difficulties. We can use PyCharm, Anaconda Navigator, Spider, Jupyter Notebook, Python IDLE. I have not worked with Java. I'm not sure whether it is better than Python. I hope Java and Python level are almost same. Which language is best in the sense? For me now, English is best. It will be good to speak or convey to everyone. So regarding this programming in the sense, it depends upon the application. Chaya Gurchoni. Who is this particular person commenting in Malayalam? Yeah, Python is useful with the embedded. Java or Python? If I say for that means both Java as well as Python, both has a platform with the same functions. Even with Java also we can create this 3D and image processing, audio processing, machine learning, deep learning, everything is possible even with that also. Till now I did not refer some books and all. I was just got experience by working in some projects only, some basic internship classes as well as with some projects. So then it can be access for music softwares, for playing the music software or pausing, changing some effects. In fact, it is also possible even with recognizing the speech or playing the recorded functions or recording the particular voice from the mic of the laptop. So this and all nothing but it is definitely possible with the help of music software. See, if you ask which of the coding language or which of the platform is best and all in the sense, it is quietly unanswerable questions. Why in the sense, for example, this Python is used in this many varieties and Java is used in that much varieties and therefore C++ also used in that much varieties. Okay, so whenever if it is going with the same varieties, so it depends upon the user's application. Okay, and if you are asking which platform the Python works, so some software list I have said you, right, like IDLE or PyCharm, Jupyter, Anaconda. So whenever if you go for like this, each and every software will be adaptable for each and every user's logical thinking. Okay,
So according to my side, for me, ideally is best. So why I am saying ideally, in the sense I can work simultaneously with the help of system, as well as the same can be worked with the help of Raspberry Pi. So both it is possible to easy to understand as well as easy to work. So I suggest for ideally. Yeah, it depends upon the user, whoever uses this particular technology or this platform. So regarding that only I can say about how is Spider or how is Anaconda like this. Anaconda is an environment navigator, whereas Jupyter Python, it is a platform for coding in with the help of URL as well as IP address online. It is a Raspberry Pi is an embedded system that works with Python. Yeah, Spider, in the sense, if you are interested to work in Spider, definitely you can go on. Even all these packages even are available with the help of Spider also. So the one of the currently going, but it has not been elaborated. So in that way, the technology is nothing but website development for framework. So currently they are using with the help of Flask, Django, like that inside the Python itself. And usually whenever we are going with embedded with Raspberry Pi, definitely we are creating the web pages with the help of PHP. So this also will play a major role for creating some website development framework regarding towards that Python or integrating towards any of these systems. And one of the technology which I have missed over here in the sense, it is blockchain. So Python nowadays, it is playing a major role, especially in machine learning. So machine learning in the sense, machine learning can be done in two different ways. One is with data and another one is with images. So image also can be set as a data. But why I mentioned that particular data, in the sense, it is statistical data. So that will be good. So whenever if we go for that statistical data, in the sense, I can give you example regarding that sales of the vehicles per year, or prediction of sales. So they have to check each and every month. Sorry, they have to check each and every month. So from the January till the December, so during that month, each and every month they have to check what was the sales going on, and then by comparing these details they have to apply some algorithms towards it, and therefore they will be able to predict what will be their sales for next year. So that is nothing but the machine will be able to understand. So in that way only. But we have to apply all the factors if you want to get an accurate output. If you are applying only the some of the factors, therefore you won't be able to get it as a good output. And similarly, for analyzing depth values, or in order to recognize any of the particular thing, whichever we give it as an input. So therefore, it is nothing but known as deep learning. For example, in future, maybe if any of them conducting webinar like me, so therefore the YouTube will be able to recognize that it is that particular person's voice. For example, if after 10 years if they have developed like this project, and if some of the voice recognizer is over there in YouTube, therefore it can able to match that this is a particular person's voice. If I am speaking this, it will say my name, or it will say my whatever the profile name has been given, right? So where this application has been implemented, in the sense, not as voice, like image it has been applied. So where, in the sense, we can say it as in Facebook or Instagram, whenever we tap on the particular person's face, it will be displaying their Facebook ID or their Insta ID. So it is nothing but the complete application of the technology, integrating this programming language towards that particular technology. Okay. So in this way only we will be able to create, or we can able to work with the complete function.
So whenever if we go for this as an end function, so what will be the other or the entire product which we receive regarding those machine learning or deep learning? So therefore it is nothing but known as artificial intelligence. So once if we create some of the projects regarding those ML or DL, therefore it will be taken as a part of artificial intelligence. Even it is also possible to combine both ML as well as DL and make it as a AI product. For example, nowadays what and all we are using, in the sense our Google Assistant or Alexa or Cortana or Siri, so these and all will be definitely can be prepared even with the help of Python. So whenever if we go for like this oriented artificial intelligence function, there will be one more integrated technology. So that is also currently a little bit famous. So this is nothing but Internet of Things. So generally the devices such as Node MCU and Raspberry Pi, Intel Edison and Jetson Nano, these and all completely can even work with the help of Python. So here I have mentioned the Node MCU, and the Node MCU is nothing but completely it works only with the help of MicroPython, and mostly everyone is using it as C language. And whereas this Python has brought a major changeover only for these three applications, such as ML, DL as well as IoT. So especially if we go with IoT, in the sense definitely the first thing which we comes in our mind is nothing but the Raspberry Pi controller. Okay, so therefore we can add the sensors, and there was one prevent comment section, nothing but power system. So if they are adding their voltage as well as the current sensors towards that particular Raspberry Pi, and therefore whenever we are applying that particular application towards it, then we will be able to accurate or what are the power system values, we can able to monitor the power system. So these are all nothing but some of the applications that have been integrating with technology in the platform of Python Kodi. So this is nothing but the complete applications. IoT is nothing but Internet of Things, the thing that is work only with the help of internet. Deep learning, in the sense the machine that analyzes each and every data as a depth analysis in a depth manner. IoT is nothing but it is a communication area. So communication, in the sense we are using internet as a communication module to communicate with a particular machine, whereas cloud computing is entirely different. It is nothing but creating a virtual area for accessing that particular storage or sharing data. So that is only the cloud. Till now, I don't know whether there is more powerful language than Python. Yeah, embedded C. It is more powerful than Python and most difficult language. Especially if you start to develop it as for Linux or RTOS like that and all. I am not aware of quantum computing. So whenever we go for the projects regarding towards Tribly, in the sense home automation or power system monitoring, applying power consumption with machine learning for future prediction, so artificial intelligence with the power system, so these and all can be taken as projects. Yeah, definitely you can use for any engineering domain this particular Python. Especially it depends upon their logical or technical thinking. Okay, so now let us see some demo regarding towards the Python. So first let us start with GUI. So generally if we go for GUI, everyone knows that pressing of buttons and how it has been created, that is one of the exclamation, right? So whenever if we go for like this function, so let me try to open this as an executable file. So now you can see this is nothing but my GUI login window that has been created with the help of AppJar. So this completely runs on with the Python execution file only. So now I am entering something over here. And to be honest, I did not type the star at all, but I was able to make it in the form of star. So this was the particular thing which I have typed over here, because I have given the condition nothing but that everything will be able to display over here whatever we are typing over here. So in this way only that particular hacking and as well as even the Google as well as the Facebook organizations and all will be remembering our passwords. So based on with the help of this particular GUI, not only GUI, this password authentication, everything can be done with the help of this function, especially in Python. So now let us see what is that simple factor that has been applied over here. So this is nothing but the some of the backend that has been done with the help of Python. So here I am calling my app jar, then first creating the button as cancel, then getting entry label for username, then again entry label for password. Then whatever it has been entered, it will be printed over here. The size of the login window, background color of the login window, then title, then what color the title should be, what color should be the foreground, and here you can see BG as well as FG. So what you will be entering the label, so the username, and another one nothing but the secret entry. So the secret entry only will be converting whatever you are typing as a into that asterisk. So nothing but that person or that place will be known as the password. If we click on submit as well as cancel, so that is nothing but regarding towards the press. So I think here there will be the button function nothing but the press. If we press cancel, therefore it will stop the function. If we press other than the cancel button, we will be getting this particular output. Therefore, where we have to keep the focus in the sense, the username, because first we have to enter the username only, and app code go in the sense, it is nothing but the complete execution. Okay, so this is nothing but the complete output which I was able to show with the help of GUI.
Okay. So this is nothing but one of the complete application, one among the application of Python. So if you go for the top trending applications regarding Python, GUI with the desktop, that is one of the common application. And for creating GUI, you just go with AppJar. AppJar is the package I am using for that particular GUI function. Or else you can go with Tkinter. So these two are the most used functions for Python GUI. So next it is nothing but interfacing cloud towards Python, so sending data towards the cloud. So nothing but here I have ThingSpeak cloud and I am just sending the data towards a particular cloud. For installing, you just type it as pip install appjar. So therefore I have logged into my ThingSpeak. And let me check. So here I am going to this particular function. Therefore go to the API key. Copy this. Just paste it over here. Here check for the field whichever you are going. So here it will be printed over field 1. And the data sent is nothing but 10. Okay, it has started to upload the data. And therefore the data has been uploaded on July 10, 2020 at the time 11:56 and the value is nothing but 10. So this is another one application regarding towards it. So this application is nothing but known as IoT Cloud Interface using Python. This ThingSpeak cloud is mostly used in IoT only. And another one is nothing but how to play the audio. So here I have a recorded audio and how it is possible to play with the help of Python. So it is very simple, only this much coding is there. We are using that play sound function. Just run the module. I have to enter the file name which is to be played. So this is nothing but .wav file name. If I am having any of the mp3 in the sense, therefore I can play any mp3 file. forgot to give that extension.
Pantech.
So I hope you all heard one particular word, nothing but known as Pantech. Similarly, if I give that MP3 file name, I would be able to play some music. So at present, I don't have any of the MP3 file. So now it is one of the most smallest thing, but it can be said as one of the important thing. Nothing but text to speech. So first let us go for speech conversion. So here this will be the speech that I have given it over, and now the system will be playing that particular speech using Python text to speech conversion.
The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog.
Okay, I hope you all heard that. So again, I will be playing it.
Brown fox jumped over the lazy dog.
So this is nothing but text to speech conversion. So whatever the text I have given over here, it will be converting into the speech.
How can I help you?
Hi. So let us see, and this is the particular thing in code itself. So this is nothing but a mini helping option with the help of a speech recognizer. This is also already available in Python. And here if I say hello, it will be replying me as hello. Then if I ask how are you, I am fine and how are you, that will be the reply. And therefore if I say the Pantech, in the sense, it will be opening this particular web page automatically. I no need to do anything. Hello.
Hello.
So this has been recorded successfully. So similarly, now you can hear that particular recorder. The recorded voice will be my voice only.
Hello.
Yeah. So therefore it is working. Pantech.
Opening.
So therefore now you can see that our web page is getting opened. So if anyone want to just inquire regarding towards like this webinars or that on behalf of your colleges, you can just approach us to these numbers, as well as you can also approach us towards training@pantechmail.com. You can also visit for the upcoming webinars that has been listed for this entire season. So everything will be updated within this particular web page itself. So generally this can be said as some of the applications regarding towards a Python. So similarly, with the help of the speech recognition, if I give more and more commands, therefore this will be able to work an entire function. So I hope you all have enjoyed this particular session. So I hope most of them has enjoyed this particular session, and thanks for your great support. If you have any queries or regarding towards your conducting webinars and all, you can just contact us, Mr. Senthil Kumar, Mr. Srinivasan, and Mr. Kumar Swami. Okay, once again thanks to all for those who have supported to reach till this as a milestone. So definitely we will be coming with a new technology. Thanks to all.